Get us there.
So the place is sold, then, Jared?
It's sold, Cloma. Son. We're too poor to be babies. We knowed last week this day was coming on us. We sold the cows and the hogs and the chickens.
Pa, I don't want to go to Florida.
I don't want to neither. That's where the work is.
I do, Jared.
Sarah, Miss Annie, you looking fit?
Got some good food for you here.
That's nice. Why don't you take it inside, Cloma? We'll be right proud to see you.
Thank you.
Cyrus.
Hey, Jared.
There's Tracy, my you-growed son. Fred.
Jared.
Well, Billy, I'm glad you came. Tom, looking fit. That steel of yours must be doing all right.
This here's my going away present to you, Jared. Now, I make the best corn liquor in West Virginia. You know that.
Yeah. I know you've been known to brag some, too.
Jared, we feel real bad about you leaving. Are you certain you can't stay and make it okay?
No way, Tom. No way at all. Price of eggs ain't worth chicken feed. Price of milk ain't worth the hay.
Jared, y'all come in now. It's time to eat.
You coming, Cloma? Well, go inside. I want to tell you all something. I'm not taking anything from the house. When we leave tomorrow, I'm not locking the door. And after we're gone, I'd like you all to come up and take whatever you want.
Now, that ain't right, Jared.
Now, that's the truth, Jared.
Now, we'll sell you things and we'll send you the money.
My own pa built this house and everything in it, almost everything. Don't seem right to sell it. You're my friends. That makes it right to give it. Let's get something to eat. After supper, we'll get a couple of fiddles and do us some stomping, huh?
I wouldn't move to Florida if my whole life depended on it.
I think you would if your whole family was going. I don't want to go, Jeff. Really, I don't.
Ain't you ever coming back?
I want to. Kiss me now, if you want. I won't mind. I guess kissing's the best thing people do.
I'm sorry, Papa. Mama, I did the best I could, but it just weren't enough. I can't do no more. I tried. Just can't be done. I purely hate to go off and leave you here alone. I never thought I would. There ain't no other way. I made sure no one will ever put plow or axe to this grove. It's in the deed. It's writ right in there so you can rest easy on that score. Maybe someday I can come back here and buy the land again. Be with you. I promise I'll do my best. I'll try. Lord be with you, Papa. Mama. Lord be with you. Rest well.
I got a strong feeling we could have a good life down here.
I just think of the same thing.
You look like you're glad we come down here.
Well, living here must be like a holiday every day. Mama, if I had one of those, would you let me wear it?
Well, I don't know. Jared, would you rather wear one of those?
Not to church, I wouldn't.
Living, selling fruits and vegetables. What do you think?
I think that's a right fine idea, Jared.
Fill it up. Any $5 worth, please?
Virginia, huh?
Folks must be tourists.
Oh, we're down here looking for work.
You picking?
Anything we can get pays a decent wage.
Job in the field is pretty hard to come by right now. About all there is around here.
You tell me there ain't no work?
Work, you gotta look to find it. There's a line up every morning over there by the packing shed. You gotta get there before sunup.
I gotta tell you, there's a lot more people than jobs.
Is that your daughter?
Yeah.
She could probably make you a few bucks while you're looking for work.
How so? These flatlanders down here ain't never sampled no mountain stuff. She'd do real well.
Listen, boy, I just now told you.
It's my daughter.
Didn't mean nothing by it. Just kidding.
Hey, I need 25 hands rope. Don't want nothing but experienced figures. 25 hands rope.
Line up here, Paul, for tickets.
All right. Yeah, line. I need 20 hands for tomatoes. Right here.
You got experience picking tomatoes?
Well, I own my own farm. I picked what I grow.
I can't use nothing but experience pickers.
No, you see, what I'm trying to tell you is that
now,
I have
my
own...
What you told me, mister, is that you never pick more than 200 tomatoes in a year. Now, I got a 60-acre field out of there I got to have cleared by this morning, and I ain't got time to fool with no hillbilly.
Do what I'm telling you.
Now, step aside. I ain't got all day to get this bus moving. Move it.
Your company?
I'm the office manager.
What kind of help you looking for?
Collector.
What does that mean, collecting from folks who can't keep up with their payments?
That's it, friend. But I don't think it'd be your kind of thing.
No, I don't neither.
Hey, wait a minute. Where are you from?
I'm from West Virginia.
How much family you got?
I got two children and a wife.
How old are your kids?
My kids are. I got a girl of 16, a boy of 14.
They're good and healthy?
They're healthy, all right, but...
How about your old lady?
I got a wife. 7 months along with a new baby. You see, I'm looking for work for myself.
You ever think of doing some picking?
Well, I sure have. I was over there at that lineup.
Yeah, that lineup don't mean nothing. You just wait here. I think I may be able to help you out.
Are you certain this is the place?
This is it, Coma. Been about 2 hours now. Tell by the sun.
Isn't this kind of a queer place to meet a man about a job?
Maybe it's close by the work.
Mr. Creedy?
You must be the folks looking for work.
Yes, sir. Name's Jared Teeter.
I hear you're from out of state.
Well, yes, sir. We're from West Virginia.
Well, I don't suppose you got no kin around these parts.
Oh, no, sir. All our kin's up in the mountains.
That's good. That's real good. Relatives always have a way of holding a man down, keeping him from realizing his full potential. You ever worked the fields in this state before?
No, sir, but you don't have to worry about that. I can do anything I put my mind to.
Them kids yours, they worthless like most young people today? Or have you thought to teach them work is character building?
Well, we're mountain folks, sir. We know what work is.
Huh. Well, I reckon you'll do. I understand you got your old lady's belly all swole up. Well, maybe she can find something to do around the camp during the day.
Camp?
And that's where you'll be staying. It's my labor camp. It's called Angel City.
We're going to get housing, too?
What have I been trying to tell you? That's where you're going to stay, at my labor camp. But first, I want you to follow me into Florida City and get you signed up for food stamps.
Well, now, Mr. Creedy, I don't need no food stamps.
How's that?
Well, sir, I never took charity in my life.
Oh, it ain't charity. It comes out of your taxes. Everybody at Angel City gets food stamps.
Yes, sir, but...
Wait, but you want to work for me or not?
Yes, sir, I sure do.
All right, well, then you'll sign up for food stamps.
Well, you...
Now, look, all you got to do is sign up for them. I'll take care of it from there. Now, come on. Follow me in.
Much, does it?
Well, come on, get on out. Let's have a look at you. That's real pretty. I wasn't informed about no dog.
That little dog's daddy was the best private dog in West Virginia. Name's Skip.
This ain't West Virginia, it's Angel City. We ain't got no rabbits around here.
That little old dog won't be no bother, Mr. Creedy.
You folks will be in room number 10. It's right around the left all the way to the end. Spend the rest of the afternoon getting settled. Buses will be leaving for the fields at 6 o'clock in the morning. Well, by the way, there'll be a little charge for the camp housing. We'll take it out of your earnings every Saturday night when you get paid. You get supper every night, but you have to look out for yourselves for breakfast and lunch. I wasn't informed about no dog. Dog's counterproductive.
Mr. Creedy? I forgot to ask you, how much does the work pay?
Well, cucumbers are 50 cents a bucket. All else pays by the hamper. If we pick fruit, it's by the tub. These days, we're picking cucumbers. The more you make, the more you get. It's up to you.
What are you doing that for?
Doing what? Why are you locking the gate?
I ain't never been locked in no place in my life.
I ain't locking you in. I'm locking other folks out. While my people is in the fields, they don't want their possessions being stole out of their rooms.
What if I want to get out?
You'll get out. You'll get out every day.
Well, Mr. Creedy, I don't know about...
You want to work for me or not? Because if you don't want to work for me, I'll let you out of here right this minute, and I won't expect to see you back here neither. Now, look, I ain't got many rules in this camp, and one of them is this. The gate stays locked while my people is in the fields. Now, what do you say? You staying or are you going?
I reckon we'll stay.
Good. That's good. I do hope you ain't gonna be counterproductive.
Outside, the air's a little.
Mr. Creedy say something about charging rent?
Yeah, he said there was a charge, a little charge.
Well, that'd be real little. Wouldn't put our hogs in there.
Well, we can clean it up. Get some buckets, mops.
It's not going to be much once it's cleaned.
Yeah, but we won't be living here long.
And don't be forgetting, you got a job. That means you got what we came here for.
That's right. Which means we're going to make some money. Get us our fruit and vegetable stand. And we'll get us another house. Come on, you get a bucket. You help your mother. I'll look for some soup. Excuse me. Oh, mister, tell me where I can get me some soap and a mop.
I's the cook. I don't pick no meters no more. I don't pick no cukes no more. And I gets two bottles of wine instead of one. You'll have to go to the store.
Gate's locked. I can't get to the store.
I's the cook. I don't pick no meters no more.
Pays 50 cents a bucket. Now, if I can pick 100 buckets a day, that's $50. And if Christy and Benny can pick 50 apiece, that's $100 a day.
That's a lot of money, Pa.
It sure is. That's $600 a week. That's more clear pay than I've ever made in a month.
Papa, those are the
this afternoon. Name's Jared Teeter. Floma? My wife Floma. Daughter Christy and Benny.
You can call me Si.
See, they locked the gates again. When they gonna open them?
Say what?
When they gonna open the gates? I gotta get to town and get me some soap.
We stops at the stove coming back from the fields every afternoon.
Maybe I can go in after supper.
Except for the fields in the morning, nobody goes outside Angel City.
At no time
whatsoever.
Well, how come?
Well, this be Angel City, and that's the way things be.
I met Jesus today.
Don't pay him no never mind. He's touched in the head, but he don't bother nobody.
Kind of be old to be working the field, ain't he?
The man's past 80. He's like a picking machine. If he wasn't such a good picker, Creedy would have killed him long time ago.
Killed him?
That your dog?
That's my dog, all right. His name is Skip.
They don't allow no dogs in Angel City. If you love him, you take him out in the fields tomorrow morning. Let him run off.
I couldn't do nothing like that.
He's your dog. Yeah. If you can have it, I don't have much call for soap these days.
Thank you. Appreciate that. Roma? What's this?
You're paying a dollar and a half for that bottle of junk, whether he likes it or not, so you best take it.
Who is that?
That'd be said. It's one of Cletus' boys. There's two of them. The black one's name is Cabo.
Don't he talk none?
Sure he talk, but you appreciate him more when he don't. You best stay clear of him.
Oh, what you mean? I got to take this whether I want it or not.
That gives you a pint of wine for a dollar and a half every day. It takes it out of your pay on Saturday.
Mr. Cree didn't say nothing about this.
I expect he didn't. But like I told you, just be Angel City. And that's the way things be. Get some bread. Come on, old man. Move it. Let's go.
Mama, the squash tastes funny.
It has sand in it, Benny.
You never washed it before it cooked it. You don't have to eat it.
Benny, there's the sardines and soda crackers in the van. Enough for everyone.
Go get them.
I'm going to look around a little.
Spoons are good. Benny?
That's the Everglades you're looking at out there. Full of snakes and alligators. I've seen lots of men go in there, but none of them come out.
Mr. Side, tell me something. The food here always that bad?
Oh, no. Sometimes it's worse. See, what we get is what the packing house throws out, and the meat, if he wants to call it meat, he buys with our food stamps. Mr. Tita, I don't know how you come to be here, but you seem like a good man to me. You ought to get your woman and your young'uns out from here. You ought to get in your van first thing in the morning and drive straight out from here without looking back.
Mr. Sy, I got a family to support. I got precious little money.
What I'm saying is you ought to get out from here before it's too late. You ain't got no business in here.
Maybe I should have turned around when I first saw this place. But I need work real bad.
Listen to me, Mr. Teeter. Angel City ain't like no other labor camp. Listen, what I'm trying to tell you is that you ought to...
Just trying to tell him what, Si?
Well, I was just telling Mr. Teeter here, you ought to feel lucky to be here in Angel City.
You're a liar, Si.
I wouldn't lie to you, Mr. Sir.
Go to your room, Si. Teeter, ain't it? That's right. I want to be your friend, Mr. Teeter. You want to be my friend? Well, sure you do. That's why I'm going to give you some friendly advice. Don't be listening to no niggers.
target too fast.
You'll last a day if you don't slow down.
More I pick, more I earn.
Listen, man, it don't make no difference how many cucumbers you pick.
What do you mean it don't make no difference? The more buckets I pick, the more I get paid. That only makes sense.
Find out on Saturday. Sure enough, will.
What's this dollar for?
That's your daily advance about food for your breakfast and lunch tomorrow. Petey takes it back on Saturday, don't you?
Well, what kind of breakfast and lunch is a dollar supposed to buy?
I don't know nothing about what it's supposed to buy. But what it do buy is a can of sardines and an apple. Of course, if you ain't got an appetite for a feast like that, you can always buy yourself a can of beer.
Wait a minute. Come on, honey. I'm going to have to talk to Mr. Creedy. I don't need this dollar. I can buy what I need from what I get paid.
Come Saturday, you might change your mind.
I don't understand what's going to happen Saturday to make me change my mind.
What did I tell you last night? I told you to get your family out of here this morning. And you didn't do it. I told you in the fields, it don't make no difference how many cubes you pick.
But that don't make no sense. You get paid by the bucket. The more buckets I pick, the more I get paid. What you're saying makes no sense.
Mr. Teeter, you ain't living in the United States of America where they got laws and unions to protect folks. You live in an angel city, Mr. Teeter.
But, Mr. Sy,
look, let me sum it up for you. Look out for your dog.
Papa. Smells just like the peach blossom back home.
Sure does. You want to buy that, don't you, honey?
Oh, no, Papa. It's $1.98. I know we can't afford it.
Well, you just should buy this. Of course, you're just the kind of girl that should smell like peach blossom.
Things will get better. It's rough out there, Cloma. The sun beating down, bending over. I feel like my back is broke.
My name's Buck.
How do I? I'm Jared Teeter. This is my wife, Cloma.
Now, picking cucumbers and sitch ain't all I knows how to do. I done bought 32 babies since I was 16 years old. And I just want you to know, when your time is here, I'll be there.
Well, I picked me 82 buckets today. That's $41.
How about you, Benny?
I got 40, Pa.
27, Papa. I'm sorry.
Well, don't be sorry, honey. You did good. We made ourselves over $70 the first day.
Come on, kid. Get washed up.
You know, Cromer, I hate to see them work so hard, but I don't know no way around it. For a while, anyway. You better keep Skip close by it during the day.
Why?
I don't rightly know, but Mr. Sy said we should be careful. Tells me that they're going to charge $1.50 a day whether we want it or not. It costs 49 cents at the store.
That ain't right.
Cloma, a lot of things around here don't seem right.
I've been wondering about something.
Well, it'd be about time.
Mr. Creedy, what did he get out of all this?
Plenty.
Like what?
He's a contractor. He gets paid $2.50 an hour for himself for all the time we in the fields. Plus, he gets $1 a head for each picker he puts in the fields, and that's every day.
It's a lot of money for one man.
Y'all don't even begin to tell it. That's just what the growers pay.
Well, now he can't make money at anything else except maybe on the vine.
On you. And me. Well, you and me and every poor critter in this field.
Oh, got to have some good in him. Every man has some good in him. The Lord tells us that.
The Lord ain't ever been in no migrant camp.
Tater.
Yeah, you and your youngs did real good for being your first 4 days.
We did work some.
Your 4 day total, 602 buckets.
It's exactly my count, Mr. Creedy.
Say, 602 buckets, that comes to $449.
Well, Mr. Creedy, I don't think we earned that much, did we?
Earn? I ain't talking about what you earned. The amount is what you owe me.
Mr. Creedy, would you mind saying that again?
You owe me $449.
Well, no, sir. Ain't no way that can be so, Mr. Creedy.
Tater, you calling me dishonest?
Well, no, sir. Mr. Creedy, there must be some mistake. There's no way I could owe you $400.
As a fee of $150 each for being put to work.
You never told me nothing about that, Mr. Creedy.
That comes to $600 for you and your bunch. $20 a week rent, that comes to $80. That's $5 for electricity. Supper is $2 each. That comes to $32 for the first 4 days. And there's $2 each for the bus to the fields for everybody.
You charge us for taking us to the fields?
And there's an advance of $1 a day for food, and wine is $1.50 a bottle. It comes to $750. You earn $301 picking. That means you are into me for $449. You understand me now?
How come you never told me this before I come here?
Would you like to work this off now, or would you like to pay it up with cash?
How come you never told me this?
Hey, wait a minute. Excuse him, Miss Creed. You understand, it's his first week in the fields, and the sun done got to him. That's it. He's talking out of his head. You understand, the sun done got to him.
That right, Teeter? The sun got to you? Well, listen, won't take you too long to work all this out, then you can start making some real money. I'm going to advance you $5 for yourself and $2.50 each for your youngins. Here's $10.
All right, let's go. Keep it moving.
Mm-hmm.
I worked hard all my life. It's the first time I've ever made a fool of them from my wife and young'uns.
Things in traps ain't fools. They're just hungry. And we'd be hungry, that's all. Like a bear in a trap or a rabbit. But like the owl in daylight, sometimes we'd be blinded.
All the camps like this?
No. Some of them kind of nice if you ain't over particular. There'd be bad ones, but I don't know none as bad as this.
I reckon I'll just have to work off my debt, and I'll be gone.
I've been here 2 years, and I ain't worked it off yet.
How come you're in debt after 2 years?
You'd be in debt if you stay here 10 years.
Well, what's the use staying? Then might just run off in the field someday.
Grady's got my boy. He's got my boy.
He got what?
I tried to run off 2 or 3 times with my boy, but they caught me and pistol whipped me till I was senseless. And last time I tried it, Grady took my boy.
He took your boy?
He took my boy to live at his place, wherever that is. He's got 5 or 6 more young'uns staying at his place. Now, you know nobody's going to try to get away with that hanging over their heads since they took him. They don't watch me too close no more. I probably could get away now and go to the police. But if I did that, Creedy would kill my boy and bury him somewhere. You see, I can't even prove I have a son. He was born in a bean field. I ain't got no records, no papers, nothing to prove that he was ever on this earth.
Where's the boy's mama?
She died 8 years ago when he was born. I buried her way out in the woods.
Has it always been like this for you, Si?
I ain't never known no difference.
I'd like to ask you this, Si. How do you know your boy's still alive?
But tomorrow's Sunday. And Sunday's the day the Creator brings the children out for a visit. And he just do that to remind us that he's got them.
I'm real sorry, Si. I'm real sorry.
Bad feeling.
Feel the same way, Bunny?
Me and Chris talked about it, Paul. Maybe when you and Mama have some money and a settle, would it be all right if Christy and me was back to the mountains?
Now, this ain't the only place in the state, you know. Ought to give us more of a chance than this.
I don't like it down here, Paul. And I never don't like it down here.
Well, I think once we got our fruit stand, maybe a nice little house, you're going to feel differently.
Benny, do me a favor. Give me some more of that firewood. Oh, sure.
Sit still, son. Finish your breakfast. I'll get it.
Give.
Stay where you are. My dog.
Don't know nothing about your dog.
Which one of you killed my dog?
Hey, sir. Did you break this poor dog's neck?
Why, no, Jambo. You know I wouldn't do a thing like that. Dog's man's best friend.
Well, let me tell you something, Cracker. If you don't get the hell out of here, that dog won't be the only snake broke today. Now move.
You shouldn't have killed my dog.
Papa, you gotta say something for Skip.
Lord, the dog's name is Skip. Never hurt no one. Just a pure dog. Never asked for much. Grateful for whatever he got. Mighty pleased, Lord. Any scraps you can give him from your heavenly table. Amen. Hey, Jabbo.
Yeah?
There's usually a lot of drinking and carrying on Sunday. Ain't none of them drinking?
Yeah, I don't like it either.
Get it done with. Now blow the horn, you get back here, you hear?
How you doing, George?
I hate that old honky.
Yeah. Yeah, sir. You keep on doing that, but don't you tell him now that you're here. Yeah, well, let's go in here and visit for a while. Say hello, Mr. Rube.
Hi, Mr. Rube.
quiet around here for a Sunday.
Yeah, it's been like this ever since that white man buried his dog.
What's the dog got to do with anything?
We don't know, Mr. Creedy, but I can smell it coming. We're going to have trouble with that man.
No, no. We're going to have no trouble with no ridge-running hillbilly.
Hey, little miss. I've been watching you now.
Just can't keep up no more,
sir. Well, sure would be a shame if a pretty little thing like you had sunstroke. Especially on a Saturday. I tell you what I'd do. You just stay along with me, and I'll pick something for your buddy, too.
That wouldn't be fair to you.
About as fair as anything in these fields. Now, come on. Yes, darling.
I feel like I'm gonna die here.
I know the feeling. I can't hardly remember a time when I wasn't in these fields. But you know, when you feel like that, you ought to sing.
Sing?
Yeah, sing. I remember a song my mama taught me. See, way back then, before we got our freedom, folk critters like me used to sing in the fields to ease our pain and make the day go shorter. I'm going home, even though the road is long. I'm going home. I'll find a way to be where I belong. Find a way. I'm going home. Just take my hand so I know where I am. I'm going home. Please take my hand. Show me where I am. I'm feeling lost, but I know when I get home, I will be safe from the storm. But I'm going to the place where I was born. Oh, I'm going home. Just take my hand so I know where I am.
One thing perfectly clear to all you niggers and rednecks and wetbacks. I want no more singing in the field. You understand me? No more singing in the field. You ain't getting paid to sing, you're getting paid to pick. Singing is counterproductive. All them people in them fancy restaurants in New York and Boston, they're waiting for these cucumbers for their salads. They'd be mighty disappointed to find out that while they're waiting, you're down here singing in the field. It's counterproductive. It's old timey. Is that right? And what I'm trying to tell you is this, singing in the fields is counterproductive to modern agriculture. Oh, Tater, see, you reduced your debt by $113.
That means you owe me $336.
Horse apples.
What'd you say?
According to work I did this week, Mr. Creedy, I don't owe you nothing but $180.50.
Look, Peter, I keep the books. You owe what I say you owe.
I'll tell you what I'm going to do, Mr. Creedy. I'm going to give you the last $50 I got in this world. I'm going to get my family and I'm going to put them in that van over there. I'm going to drive out of here and I ain't never going to look back. I'm going through them gates and there ain't nobody going to stop me.
Nobody leaves Angel City owing me money. You understand? Nobody leaves Angel City owing me money.
I'm going through them gates. Ain't nobody going to stop me.
Nobody leaves Angel City owing me money. Nobody. Get him back to his room. Jerk that battery out of his old van.
What did you do to him? What did you do to my husband?
Drugstore and get us some medicine. I'll give you $40. Let me out the gate tonight.
How do I know you come back?
I'm not going to leave my wife and children here.
You got the money?
I just seen a strange thing. I just seen you talking to Chapel.
I gave him $40, let me out the gate tonight.
What?
I told him Plum was sick and needed medicine. Really gone to the police.
Don't try it, Mr. Teeter.
I got to.
Thank you.
Well, what should we do with him? Dump him in a sinkhole?
Nah. Mr. Creed said bring him back to camp. We're going to take his girl.
Let's get him out.
Okay, girl, you coming with me. Let's go.
Come on.
Don't you
touch her. Go. No, please. No, please. No, please. No, don't take her. No, please. Please. Mama. No, please. Help me.
Leave that girl alone. Why don't you get the hell out of the way? I'll settle with you later.
I tried to go to the police. I did my best to talk him out of it, Miss Cloma.
Angel City? Run, man. Run.
But you said these gates were always locked.
Well, like you found old Teeter, huh?
I guess you figured out by now he ain't quite right in the head.
You Creedy?
Yeah, Jack Creedy. I'm a contractor here. I run this camp.
Well, Mr. Teeter here had been telling me some pretty bad things about you.
Well, I ain't a bit surprised. The poor soul's got bugs in his head. I do what I can for him, but every now and then he has a fit and runs off. You can go ask his wife.
Mr. Teeter says that you're holding his daughter and some other children. House.
My house? What house? I live right here, right behind the office.
He's lying. My daughter at his house. Jabbo and Sud live here.
Jabbo and Sud? I don't know what he's talking about. And what daughter? He never had no girl when he come to this camp. It was just him and his wife and his boy.
How'd this man's face get so beat up?
Well, how am I supposed to know? He was out running around the woods all last night. What happened, Teeter? You fall down, you run into something?
Then this man says a lie, officer. You don't mind if I look around a little bit, do you?
No. Go right ahead, officer. My camp's just like any other camp. Reckon you forgot where your daughter's at, didn't you, Teeter?
Can you fellas leave this camp?
We can leave this camp when we want to.
That's all right now. You can just tell the man the truth. Is there anything you want to say to me? Any of you? Now, they're lying now to you. There's no need to lie. Just tell the man the truth. Tell the man the truth. Come on, tell him! Nobody can leave. Just nobody can leave. Here, come over here. I'll prove it to you. They took my battery, see? So we couldn't leave neither. They're just afraid to talk to you. Where's your wife, Mr. Teeter?
She's over here.
Is this man your husband?
Yes, sir.
Where's your daughter, ma'am?
Daughter?
Yes, your husband says Mr. Creedy came and took her away.
We don't have a daughter. Benny here's our only child.
Grandma.
You know we don't have a daughter, Jared.
Grandma?
She's lying, officer. I'm telling you, she's lying. Si, you tell him. He's got your son just like he's got my daughter. Tell him. Tell him!
I ain't got no son.
Her name's Christy. She's 16.
I don't know what to say to you, Mr. Teeter.
Her name's Christy Teeter. She's 16-year-old. Creedy, he's got them all scared.
Well, officer, are you satisfied?
That's a mighty fancy car for a labor contractor.
Oh, I earned every penny I paid for it. I go out in the fields and work every day with my people. Any more questions?
Yes. Why do you have this camp all fenced in like a prison compound?
No, officer, you mean to tell me this country's gone so far downhill that a man has to justify fencing his own property?
I guess not, Mr. Creedy. But this place doesn't look right or feel right to me. And I'll tell you something else. I get the feeling that the people in this camp are so browbeaten that I can't get any real cooperation. I may be seeing you again.
You're not going to leave, are you?
Mr. Teeter, what can I do? Your own wife won't even back you up. I'm sorry.
Come here. Whooping you didn't do no good, did it? So I'm going to tell you right now, and you best remember it. You ever pull another stunt like you pulled last night, you'll never see your little girl again. You hear what I'm telling you?
I hear you, Mr. Creedy.
You are going to stop being counterproductive. You owe me money. You owe me money, and you're gonna pay it. Now go lock the gate.
Lies, Jared. I had to.
I know.
Creedy said. He said that we wouldn't see Christy again. And what could I do?
It's all right, Clump. I understand.
You ain't planning something else now, is you?
Just dreaming.
Say what?
Just dreaming about what was gonna happen when all this was over. Me and Chloe and the kids. We was thinking about getting us a roadside stand, sell fruits and vegetables and things for people passing by on the highway. You know, it'd be a whole lot quicker me getting that roadside stand if I had a partner. Two saving instead of one.
Oh, what you saying?
Just thinking, maybe you'd think about being my partner. Equal partners, 50-50.
You're crazy. How does something got to your head?
Maybe we could get a little patch of earth out behind the roadside stand.
Huh?
Grow our own vegetables.
You really want me for a partner?
Seems right.
Well, let me ask you one question. When we get this roadside stand, will we have to grow cucumbers?
No cucumbers.
Uh-huh. Well, would we have to sell cucumbers?
No cucumbers.
Well, we have to talk to people who eats cucumbers.
We'd have to get one thing real clear before we become partners. We don't talk to nobody who eats cucumbers.
What you so happy about, boy?
I got me a dream.
I'm gonna need your help. I'm having my baby.
As the cook, I don't pick no tomatoes no more.
No, you don't understand. I need your help.
As the cook, I don't pick no tomatoes or no cukes no more. And I get two bottles of wine instead of one.
Child is white.
Oh,
right.
You did good. You did good, Alma.
I reckon there's another Jared in the family.
Cloma, if you don't mind, I'd like to give him another name.
Well, you got yourself quite a brother there, Benny.
Is Mom all right?
She's fine. We named the baby Cy after you.
You want to name your boy after somebody like me?
Got somebody like you for a partner, don't I? Why not have somebody like you a godfather for my son?
Now, wait a minute. I ain't never been a godfather before. What do I have to do?
Nothing. If something happens to me, you watch over the boy.
All right, well, look at him. You too, Betty. Miss Clover.
I reckon you know his name.
If you told me. Imagine me a godfather.
They shouldn't be doing that. Leave that to themselves.
Yeah, there are things besides food make people full, Miss Clover. There's good people.
I got the apples, Pa. I picked out 6 feet, the biggest one.
Good, son, good. What do you think we ought to buy Christy?
Yellow bikini.
They don't sell them here.
Well, she does like sweet-smelling waterbed and anything, Pa.
That's good. That's good, son. You go over there and get yourself the biggest bottle of that sweet-smelling stuff, okay?
You spend about last year money, ain't you, Pa?
Christmas time, son. Christmas time.
Get on out. In a couple of hours, and your folks, Chris.
Thanks.
Thank you, Mr. Crady.
I don't know what it is about Christmas. I just want everybody to be happy.
I know. We all miss West Virginia this Christmas time, but here, I think we all celebrate it. Misty. Flomo. Yes, son.
Jared, you shouldn't have done it. I know how little money you got left. I sure do thank you. Oh, it's so pretty, Jared.
I knew you lost your comb brush on the way down here.
Oh, I never had one as good as this one, Pa.
Merry Christmas, Benny.
Christy, aren't you going to open your Christmas present? Well, come on, Christy. Open it up and let's see what it is. Well, smell of it, Christy. It smells like peach blossoms.
Your brother Benny picked it out for you, honey.
Peach blossoms don't mean nothing no more.
Billy, I need your help outside to get those bottles. Come on. Christmas, honey. We're gonna have a party just like we always did.
Would be Christmas in West Virginia. There ain't no Christmas here.
No, that's not true, Christy. It's Christmas everywhere. God, just even West Virginia.
Much to offer except these apples and this wine, but we'd be mighty proud to have you share it with us.
Thank you, Mr.
Jared.
Merry Christmas.
Jared, I'm going to take a sign
from the bed. All right, Loma. Now here, come on, let's have a little of this wine over here.
Here you go.
Merry Christmas.
Mr. Creedy is ready to leave now. He said, tell you he's done with a girl. She can stay here and work in the field.
He wants the baby.
He what?
Mr. Creedy said you can have the girl back. She tried her, and he ain't much of a woman. He's taking the baby.
You touch my baby, it'd be the last thing you ever touch.
Your baby.
That's right, my baby. Ah!
All right. Mr. Creedy's got something coming. Are you with me, Si?
I'm with you.
I'm with you too, Pa.
Stay here.
Yeah.
Oh, your mama. Come on, Si. Come on.
Why don't you go see what's keeping him?
Girl's gonna be all right because she's good people. Hey, you don't want to go to prison for killing this scum.
Yeah? You gave me something for the first time in my life. Don't take it away, man. Please.
Over. Your family's the band. Come on, now, let's go. Everybody else is gone.
Go.
Gone. Come on, we're the last ones. Let's go.
If you put a bullet in that sucker, you ain't gonna never see our baby grow up.
Come
you.
I love you, too.
Mom and me both love you, just like we did back home, West Virginia.
I love you, too.
I'll tell you something else. Peach Blossoms ain't changed. You know what we're going to do first thing when we get where we're going? I'll get you a bathing suit, get you out in that ocean. Si, Benny wants to know where we're going.
We're going wherever the dream takes us.
I'm going home. Even though the road is long, I'm going home. I'll find a way to be where I belong. I'll find a way. My hand so I know where I am. Place that hasn't changed since I was born.